I move to discharge the Committee on Governmental Operations from further consideration of Assembly Bill A-3888, sponsored by myself, for the purpose of bringing the same before the House for its immediate consideration, and request permission to explain it.
The motion is in order, and on the motion, Mr. Murray.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The bill that I'd like to bring forth, as I said, is Assembly Bill 3888, which requires fiscal impact notes on legislation impacting local governments and invalidates bills that fail to include this certain information. You know, according to the New York State Association of Counties, for a typical county, up to 80%. And by the way, it's interesting that Mr. Molinaro, the county executive of Dutchess County, is here today. He can back this up. 80% of the entire budget is required spending as directed by the state or federal government. Of course, the sequela is that this will bring about a tax increase to the taxpayers. You know, in terms of property taxes paid as a share of home value, 13 of the nation's 15 highest tax counties are in New York, primarily upstate, although Suffolk and Nassau on Long Island are quite high as well. Little to no mandate relief has been provided since the passage of the real property tax cap, and in fact, the Assembly continually passes legislation, adding on more mandated costs to localities. Between 2001 and 2016, the Assembly voted 185 times to pass unfunded mandate legislation, which would have placed an additional fiscal burden on our localities of over $121 billion. See, many times we get these pieces of legislation and we don't realize what kind of an unfunded mandate or what kind of an impact this can have on local governments or school districts, and as I said, as a result, on the taxpayers. So it's important that we have these fiscal impact notes. It's time that we ensure that the members of the state legislature are aware of the impact of every bill that we vote on, and that it will have an impact on localities. And we need to begin to reverse the burden of state mandates that we place on these localities. This legislation would not only require fiscal impact notes on all legislation impacting local governments, detailing the annual cost to the localities and clearly identifying a funding source of such annual cost, but it would also invalidate bills if the required fiscal note omits details of the funding source or results in an unfunded mandate to a specific locality in excess of 10,000 or 1 million statewide. I'd like to add one other note. Not many of us were in this body in 1996, but just as an interesting note, this bill, or one extremely similar to this bill, passed this House in 1996 by a 142-4 vote. So it'll be interesting to see how this turns out. For this reason, I urge my colleagues to vote yes on this important piece of legislation. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.